Let's create an NPS survey with follow-up questions using the free SurveyJS Survey Creator. Go to SurveyJS website and click on Creator link. You will see the Survey Creator, where you may use immediately without any registration. On the left, you will see the list of available questions. For NPS survey, we need rating question. Click on it or drop it into the page. First, let's change its title from question 1. Click on the question title and in the in-place editor type your question. For example, on a scale of 0 to 10, how likely are you to recommend our product to a friend or a colleague? And press enter. Now we need to change the numbers from 1 to 5 into from 0 to 10. The fastest way to do it is to click on edit button and in the question editor change minimum rate to 0 and maximum rate to 10. To make sure that our clients do not put the rating opposite, we can set minimum and maximum rate description. We may type the text most unlikely and most likely for them accordingly. Finally, it's a good idea to have a question name that tells what this question is about. That is why we will change the question name from question 1 to NPS score and press OK to apply the changes. Now it's time to add an open-ended question. We will need comment question for this. Click a comment question on the toolbox to append it to the bottom of the current page or drag it to the bottom of the rating survey and drop it. Let's change its title to "What is the primary reason for your score?" We have just created a simple survey and we can test it. Click on the Test Survey tab and let's test it. In Test Survey, click on 3 and type "Sorry, did not use it much" and press Complete button. Click on S Table and S JSON results. Here we can see our survey results during the testing. So far so good, except couple things. At first we have a small survey and we don't need question numbers here. To remove them, click on Survey Settings button and go to the Question tab. Here change the Show Question Numbers option from default on to off and click OK. Secondly, we don't want to show our open-ended question until the user selects score. Let's select the question, click on Edit button to show question editor and go to Visible If tab. Here we select question and NPS score is not empty in second selector and click Add. We will see a new created expression, NPS score not empty. It tells Survey to make the question visible when NPS score question has a value. Click OK to apply the changes. Finally, let's make the NPS score question as required. A user will not be able to finish the survey without setting a score. Select the question and click on Is Required button. Also, you may set the same property in the question editor. Let's test it again. You may see that we see only NPS score question. If we click Complete button without answering the question, an error message will be shown. On clicking any score, the second question is shown. Click on 3 and type again. Sorry, did not use it much. Click Complete. Let's say that you want to have different questions for your promoters, passives and detractors. Your promoters may provide you a better feedback and help you understand your product strength. It means you have a chance to ask them more questions. Let's do it. We may ask the question, what features do you value the most? If you want to allow your users choose only one answer, then it is better to use radio group question. Let's drop it and set needed properties. Go to the question editor, name it as promoter features, change title to what features do you value the most, visible if to NPS score greater than or equal to 9, go to choices and replace the item with performance, stability, user interface and complete functionality. And change column count to 2 to show items in 2 columns. You may change the item's text and add new or remove existing items using in-place editors. If you feel that you may miss a functionality, then you may add another item where a user may enter his most value feature that he did not find in your list. Go to the question editor, expand the choices tab and set as other and change the default other text from other described to other feature. Finally, make the question required. For customers who left a passive rating, you may have a question about improving the experience. Let's modify our common question in question editor. Name it as passive experience, title to can we improve your experience, and visible if expression to more than 6 and less than 9. Change in the text NPS score not empty to NPS score greater than 6, and via drop box NPS score less 9. As a result, NPS score greater 6 and less than 9. Finally, for all customers, including the detractors, we show the open-ended question. What do you miss and what was disappointing in your experience with us? We will show it for all users as soon as they select the score. Drop a new comment question, go to question editor, name it as disappointed experience, title to what do you miss and what was disappointing in your experience with us, and visible if to NPS score not empty. Let's test it again. Select 9, then performance and type faster support service, press complete and show a stable and as a JSON result. Back to designer. Let's allow to choose one or two features for promoters. We must change the radio group question to checkbox. We can do it via drop-down in the top right corner of the question that shows the question type. Change it to checkbox. The go to property grid for advanced functionality and open validators editor. Add answer count validator and set maximum count to 2. And text to please select 2 features maximum. Let us test it. Select 9 and any 3 features. Press complete and show the error. Unselect 1 and do complete. Finally, it is a good idea to have different thank you messages for promoters, passive and detractors. The easiest way to do it is to put the thank you message for passive users into completed HTML property, and for others use completed HTML on condition property. Let's go to survey settings and completed HTML tab and type. Thank you for your feedback. Your thoughts and ideas will help us to create a great product. Then go to completed HTML on condition and click on plus sign to add the first item for promoters. Set NPS score greater 8 and type in HTML. Thank you for your feedback. We're glad that you love our product. Your ideas and suggestions will help us to make our product even better. And for detractors, create another item, set the expression to less than 6 and HTML to thank you for your feedback. We are glad that you share us with your ideas. We highly value all suggestions from our customers. We do our best to improve the product and reach your expectation. Now we can try these different thank you pages out. Go to Test Survey tab and show the different thank you pages for NPS score 4, 8 and 9. We show very basic functionality of SurveyJS Creator that allows us to build NPS survey with follow-up questions. At the very end, we show the JSON editor. Here is the definition of this survey that you may share with your colleague or use it to run SurveyJS surveys on your website.